He was the best punter in the league last year. He is preseason All-Missouri Valley this year, and he currently holds the SIU record for career punting average. He's a junior from Glenbard North in suburban Chicago, Scott Ravanesi.
Scott, your career, is it going pretty much the way you thought it would?
When I came in here, you know, they recruited me late and didn't really know where I was going out of high school. Kind of came in here. The punting spot was open, and, you know, Coach Kill came up to me as a freshman and said, hey, you know, you got a good shot at this. Spot. I want you to, you know, if you work hard and do the right things, you're going to get it. And I'd say it's gone a lot better than I thought. Just my success on the field and definitely in school has been way more than I thought it would be.
The academic side has been better too, huh?
Yeah.
Well, better than you thought?
Yeah, my parents are the most proud of me about that because I've been getting, you know, good grades, but hopefully that continues.
You were at 39 per punt as a freshman, and you went to 46 last year. What happened to make that jump?
Freshman year, it was more all leg strength. It was more of the weight room. And, you know, during that off season between my freshman and sophomore year, I, you know, really hit the weights, but I really concentrated on my flexibility so I get that lift and that drive. And I think that's the biggest difference.
Can you elaborate on the flexibility and the lift and the drive and how being flexible helps you?
You know, obviously you see those punters all the time, their knee hits their helmet. And what flexibility does for a kicker, I mean, the more you get your leg extended up in the air, that's where the ball's going to go. And, you know, I've been trying to turn it over, get those spirals. I mean, that adds another 5 yards. And with the flexibility, that's what helps, gets that drive up in the air. You know, sometimes the wind carries it. Mm-hmm. I turn it over a lot more than I did my freshman year.
What's been your favorite punt, the 83-yarder against UMass?
I'd probably say that because, you know, it was on ESPN.
It was a bomb.
Yeah. Well, it was, you know, I give Travis a lot of heat about that because, you know, it was, I think I was on the end line and, you know, it was kind of a bad snap. And I picked it up and I just kind of rushed it and I hit it good. And then, you know, the best part was all my family members and friends calling me because I think it was on ESPN. They're like, hey, we saw your punt. I'm like, yeah, it's kind of lucky he didn't catch that because it wasn't the greatest punt, but he just didn't catch it. It just took a hop, lucky hop and it kept on rolling. So,
how about your favorite game? You punted too much for the team's sake against Delaware last year, and that was your best game statistically. Was that your favorite game?
No, it's hard to say it's my favorite game because it didn't turn out the way that we wanted it to. Mm-hmm. But as far as maybe memories go, as far as my 2 years here, I'd have to say maybe Northern last year was my favorite because that's a half hour away from my house. I had a lot of family there, and you know, it was probably one of the craziest, greatest games I've been in. So I'd have to say that game so far, but hopefully something else comes up.
You've also killed some inside the 20 and inside the 10 in tight ball games. That has to be a rush, too.
My job's all field position, so, I mean, the defense always comes up to me, hey, give us that good field. And, you know, that's my job. I just try, you know, try kicking it to the 10 pretty much. So, because if you aim too deep, you know, you don't know. I really don't have control over the bounce. That's what I'm trying to work on. And so I aim at about the 10, and, you know, if it takes that good bounce or if I hang it up there, you know, anywhere the 10, you know, it's 10 more yards they have to go rather than it was the touchback. So,
I'm guessing that getting one blocked against Northwestern for the first time in your career hacked you off.
We haven't got one blocked, me and yeah. Travis, and, you know, it aggravated me. But, I mean, we could learn a lot from that. You know, it's good that – it's not good that it happened, but, you know, it might have been good that it happened earlier in the year rather than later in the year. And, you know, we're going to learn from that. You know, maybe I took a little bit too much time. A guy came out the middle, everything. You know, it was just a bad play on our part as a team. And, you know, we're going to learn from it. We watched film on it. We talked about it. So it's not going to happen again.
You have a new coach. What's the difference punting for Lennon versus punting for Kill?
Coach Kill is kind of an in-your-face guy. He would yell at you if, you know, both strategies work. Coach Kill would yell, scream, kind of intimidate you. To do good, whereas Coach Lennon, he's really laid back, you know, doesn't yell that much at me, I guess. But, I mean, both strategies work because Coach Lennon, I mean, he's an easy guy to work hard for because he's such a nice guy and, you know, you just want to do good for him just because he's such a good guy.
Even though you weren't recruited late, were you kind of predestined for Southern because both of your parents graduated from here?
Kind of a weird story how I came here. Chris Arthurs, our defensive tackle, you know, I've known him almost my whole life, and we were playing his high school in basketball during the winter, and I was playing at his school at Wheaton South, and he just took his visit there, and while I was inbounding a ball, it was a timeout, and he's like, hey, Scott, you should send your tape to Southern. He's like, I just took my visit there. I had an awesome time. I'm going there. I'm like, all right, you know, I will. And, you know, I just sent a tape just thinking, you know, I might as well give it a shot. Sure enough, one of the coaches called me and said, hey, we're interested. And so that's kind of the story when it's kind of weird. And then ever since then, you know, especially, you know, my parents, but they both went here. So, I mean, that was a big influence. They told me a lot about the school, said it was a great place. So, I mean, yeah, I guess it's kind of destined for me to come here. So
your parents are happy you're here, though, I bet.
Oh, yeah. I mean, it's kind of weird because when both my parents went here, and when we came down here for the first time, it was my dad's first time coming back in 20 years. And we go down 13, and he's just like, wow, this is crazy. You know, all
don't
the
go here, don't go
yeah,
here.
The Walmart, the Best Buy, he said everything's changed. I mean, for the better, he said. So. Sure.
Scott, thank you.
All right,
good luck.
Thanks a lot. Appreciate it.
Scott Ravanesi, SIU against Northern Iowa. This is a public service announcement. This is only a test. Ravanesi standing in the shadows of his own goalpost. There's the snap. It's a good one. They blocked it well, and he kicks it out of there, and he hammered a beauty of a kick all the way back to the 35-yard line. Gray watches it hop to him at the 32. He steps up to the 35, and Bloomfield made the tackle. And Scott Ravanesi, you are the man right
guys,
now.
Guys, it does not get much better than that for a kicker.
Oh, my goodness.
I will never, ever say anything bad about a punter again in my entire life if the Slukies win this game. You need to interview this guy every week.
He is one of the candidates for the Marion Toyota Player of the Game.
And he deserves every bit
Nobody
of it.
Nobody was more surprised than Gray.
He blasted the heck out of that punt at the 36-yard line.
64 yards. A four-yard return by Johnny Gray.
That's not Ravanesi's longest. The 83-yarder is the longest. He got that against UMass. But the 64-yarder is one he'll remember.